December 7th, 1941. This was the attack on Pearl Harbor. Pearl Harbor was an American Navy base located in Hawaii, where the Japanese attacked with 353 fighter planes. Over 2,400 American men were killed, and another 1,100 wounded. It was a complete shock to America. President FDR said that it will forever be a date that will live in infamy. Japan was hoping their attack would scare off the Americans. They probably thought this because they were idiots. Patriotism in the U.S. skyrocketed. When Japan wanted to lower their morale by murdering fellow Americans, all they achieved was a country working together stronger than ever to bring them down. By the end of the war, America's army will have multiplied to 15 times its original size. America joining the Allies astronomically increased their chances of winning the war. Not only did they bring ingenuity and strategy, but also advanced weaponry, such as the Browning machine gun and the rocket launcher M1, also known as the bazooka. Thanks to the American army, the ratio of soldiers fighting for the Allies versus Germany was 7-2, and for armored vehicles, it was 4-1. Even though Germany strategically had the upper hand, our raw number of war materials led to a significant win in numerous battles, such as that at Normandy. Deadly German technology, such as the Jagdpanzer, would have been impossible to combat without American advancements. After retaking France, America moved on to the Netherlands, further crushing the Germans, as the following authentic footage straight from 1944 portrays.
No, wait! Wait for the signal!
After taking back the Netherlands, the Americans moved on to Belgium, where the final battle of the Atlantic Theater took place, the Battle of the Bulge. This was fought December 16, 1944, and was over in less than 2 months. Germany's last offensive was against the American 99th Infantry. Even though the U.S. was outnumbered 5-1, they were able to inflict casualties 18-1. That means every American soldier was 90 times as deadly as a German soldier. Nice. Now that Germany had surrendered and Hitler had committed suicide, also nice, America had to continue the battle on the Pacific front against their first aggressor, Japan. In order to gradually gain victories all over the country, America used a strategy known as island hopping. Ever so slowly, American troops jumped from Japanese island to Japanese island, forcing the oppressive Japanese troops to retreat and toppling their dictatorship. Another major motivation for the Americans was freeing their fellow POWs that were being harshly mistreated in the Japanese camps. They were overworked, underfed, and often beaten to death. One of the most notable battles during this period was the battle at Iwo Jima. This was a major victory for the U.S., as the casualties for American troops to Japanese troops was 1-3. This is also the battle where the famous photograph was taken of the four soldiers hoisting up an American flag. Nice. The following footage, also straight from World War II, portrays the horrific tragedies that ensued during battles such as these. One advantage neither the Allies nor the Axis were counting on was America gaining the knowledge of the atomic bomb. Starting in 1942, over 100,000 scientists worked on the development of the atomic bomb in 37 installations and 13 university laboratories. This was called the Manhattan Project and was the largest scientific effort undertaken at that time. Its cost ended up weighing in at over $20 billion. The charismatic leader of the group was named J. Robert Oppenheimer. He managed to bring in some of the brightest scientists in the world, such as Albert Einstein and Richard Feynman. FDR threatened the Emperor of Japan, Hirohito, to surrender or suffer the wrath of this bomb. Hirohito refused, so FDR dropped a bomb on Hiroshima. When Japan was still unrelenting, another bomb was dropped on Nagasaki. These bombs killed over 120,000 people instantly, and another 200,000 due to sicknesses and ailments. Finally, Hirohito had no choice but to surrender the war. The Axis and Allies got together in Paris for the Paris Peace Conference. Numerous treaties were signed to completely end the war in Europe for major and minor countries supporting the Allies and Axis. On December 13th, 1946, all hostilities between the United States and the Axis were ceased. Moral of the story, even though America isn't the greatest country, oh wait, it is the greatest country!